Hello friends, welcome to KK Java Tutorials. In this video, we will learn about case statements in shell scripting. Yeah. So guys, as you know, multiple if else if statements to perform a multi way branch, right? That we have seen in the previous video tutorial. However, this is not always the best solution, especially when all of the branches depends on the value of the single variable. Linux shell scripting supports a case statement which handles exactly this situation, and it does so more efficiently than repeated if else if statements, right? So here let's see how we can use a case statement. Yeah, so here if I talk about the general syntax of case statement, which is something like this in the shell scripting world. So first of all, you need to use the case, it's a keyword, and then after you have to specify the expression or any word, right? So here, this is the expression, and after that you have to specify a keyword is called in, and this is with the pattern 1, then pattern 2, pattern 3, and so on, right? And finally you have a default case, right? So here if pattern 1 is getting matched, then all the statement within this pattern 1 is going to execute, right? So here there could be a less list of commands or statement which will be executed if a pattern 1 is matching with this expression, right? And once your statement is got over, then finally you have to give double colon sign. Similarly, similar stuff will be repeated. So next would be for pattern 2, and if this pattern 2 is matching with this expression, then all the statement within this basically expression or pattern is going to execute. Similarly, you can have a multiple patterns specify over here. If none of the pattern is matching, then finally default asterisk means default, right? If you look into the meaning of asterisks, asterisk in Linux or Unix, asterisk means anything, right? So if none of the pattern getting matched, then this default pattern would be executed, and here you can have some kind of validation or some error message you can report to the basically user, right? And finally you have to end this case, so just you have to write the reverse of case, right? So ESAC, so ESAC, right? So you have to end with this ESAC, right? So this is indicating that my switch case has been done, right? So let's try to understand through an example how basically we can execute a switch case basically, or case statement in scripting, right? Shell scripting. So here I'm going to remove this stuff, and here you can see I have already created a file, is called switchcase.sh. so this is a scripting file. Now here I'm going to use cbind, and then I'm going to use bin/bash, right? I'm using bash shell, but you can use other shell as well. Now here I'm going to take a very simple scenario. There I'm going to take input from the user, so I will say read, and then after I'm going to specify p flag, and here I will prompt a message, enter role, right? So just I'm asking to the user, just enter the role from the keyboard, and enter role I will save into this variable is called role, right? And now I'm going to write a case statement right based on this role. So I will write case, and in double bracket I would like to access this variable, role variable, so I will say dollar role, right? So this is basically expression, right? Now you have to write in keyword, and as I said, after that you have to give once you are done with this, then you have to give the pattern, right? So here basically I'm going to specify a pattern, something is called, let's say first pattern I'm going to specify in double quotes, and let's say this is admin, right? Let's say user enters admin, and bracket you have to close, then I'm going to print, let's say echo, let's say you are on this role, let's say user is basically entering admin, so this will print you are admin, and here you can do admin related stuff, and finally I will print echo. So here basically in real scenario you can have a set of command to be executed for admin. Here I will say just a message thanks. So here you can have a multiple basically a statement or commands, right? And finally, as I said, this should end with the double semicolon, right? Now here you can have a multiple roles or multiple pattern you can define. So here I'm going to define three pattern. First for admin, second for let's say developer, right? If you user enter developer as input, then these are the things is going to execute. And finally let's say manager, right? And this is the code is going to execute. But last but not the least, let's say user is entering something else apart from the admin, developer or manager, then I want one default case to be executed, right? So default case can be represented by the asterisk as we have seen, right? So here I will echo, and here I'll say invalid role, and whatever role is going to enter by the user, right? Sorry. Right? Invalid role, that's it. And of course, this has to end with the double semicolon as well. And finally, you have to end this case statement, right? So you have to write something is called a reverse of case. So I will write isec, right? That's it. We are almost done, right? So let's see how this switch case is going to execute. So I'm going to run this guy. So to run this script, you have to write period then forward slash then your script name, right? So switch case dot sh. So here I'm going to enter nothing. I'm going to enter. Just I'm pressing enter. So if you do not enter anything, then invalid case is going to match and it's printing invalid role, right? Now let me run once again, and here at this time I'm going to basically enter a role as admin. And if I press enter saying that you are admin, this space of code is going to execute, right? Because this is matching with the input, right? Similarly, if I enter some other input, let's say developer, then saying you are developer, thanks, right? And similarly, same will be executed for the manager role as a manager, right? And if you enter something else, let's say I'm entering hi, this is not going to match with any role. So this is saying that invalid role hi, right? So that's how basically you work with the case statement in scripting, right? Cell scripting. So this is really, really very simple example of a case statement. But here, as I said, here instead of just giving one string or any hard coded value, you can have some kind of regular expression as well, right? And if input is matching with that regular expression, then corresponding case will be executed, right? Here thing is that one thing you should note over here, if one case is matched, then the rest of the other cases is going to escape, right? So at one time one case is going to execute. If none of the cases is matching, then finally default case gets executed. Yeah, so that's all I wanted to say in this video tutorial, guys. Big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.